Hey guys, Hobbs here. Welcome to day 5 of the 30-day video marathon. This was probably the hardest day for me to make because I finally cleared out my terabyte hard drive. I've got another terabyte to go through, but this is going to allow me to actually start playing some Diablo instead of just editing it. The last 3 days, I haven't been able to even play at all. Other than today, I'm in nightmare mode right now. I got to solo the Skeleton King in Nightmare, even though I did have, I think, my Templar with me. So solo with an NPC or two. And it got me thinking of how much cooler Nightmare is. All the gold drops faster. The mobs are quicker. You get those little laser beams that spin around that you have to avoid. That's really the only time that I died through it all was those things. So everybody was saying, oh, it's going to be so much harder. I've noticed a difference, don't get me wrong. It is more difficult. I just feel that, you know, of course, your gear scales and everything else. So it's all basically relative. You know, you got better gear, you can hit harder, you can take more damage. They deal more damage. They need harder hits to bring them down because they got more health points. It is a lot more fun, though, so far. Looking forward, I'm going to blaze through quicker in Nightmare than I did on the normal version because I found out a new way to edit all this footage. What I'm going to do now is, you know, Fraps is really nice where it captures everything. So I can get a video that's like literally an hour long. Problem with an hour long video is you got to go through it all. Even all those times that, you know, you're AFK, the times that you're selling and trading. And really you want to find the epic moments like I have here. I went through hours just to find all the bosses that were unique. The rare finds, the purples, the yellows. And just kind of give them tribute because everybody else is giving tribute to all the main bosses. So I want to do something different because, I mean, you guys have seen every main boss on everybody's channel. I love how that one boss just flew in there. It was pretty epic, you know, came right in where the camera and these barriers that they put are pretty awesome as well. Except for I can't stand when you got to chase mobs down because for some reason I run pretty slow. I like having the leap. You know, I'm still messing around with my spec and what's working for me now is working, and I enjoy having the leap because sometimes I can leap towards the mobs, and I think when I land, it gives me more armor. But I mean, I've specced a few different ways over the past few levels. Anyways, my point being, I went off track there talking about the boss that was on the screen. What my point is now what I'm going to do is when I edit the film, if there's an epic moment, right after that epic moment happens, I'm going to stop the recording real quick and start it up again. That way it creates a new file. And then when I go through the editing process, I know that all the stuff beforehand is junk that I don't really want to share with you guys. But the moment I find something that's, you know, too good to pass up, or it's a good AOE, or it's a rare mob, or it's something, an achievement that I want to share, I'll just quickly press, you know, end the clip. That way, when I go to edit, I'll just look at all the ends of the clips and I don't have to sit there and rewatch. Because I'll tell you, Diablo is a fun game to watch. But try watching. I've got 25 hours in and I've watched everything over. And I'm thinking, you know how high a level I could be if I didn't actually, you know, rewatch everything to find these moments? And hopefully this will cut down on that so I can, you know, stop editing and start leveling. So now that we're this deep into the video, most of the people who have short attention spans have left. And you got to hear my voice crack there. Most people have left. And the thing is, guys, Diablo 3, I'm finding, is a hard game to commentary on because it's just a 2D, it's a 3D, I know, world. But it's, you know, one camera perspective where at least when I was doing WoW or other games, I can flip around and feel to keep it more interesting. And I think right now it feels like it's a podcast with a visual. At the same time, though, I know as I get into the auction house and the real life auction house goes live, that's where I think I'm going to excel. The other future plans is I want to do some more WoW videos for you guys as well. Today the beta server was down, so I was actually planning on getting one out for you, but I needed some footage from there, and then just before I finished editing this up, I went and checked, and it's back up again. So I'll bring that out tomorrow. The nice thing, I'm really enjoying bringing it out once a day because I'm feeling like I'm hanging out again. I'm more interactive, more part of the community, as they say. Here I zoom in, watch this to get you guys a great footage of the boss dying, and yet this this column in the way, like this little tower, it blocks that great footage. But then watch when he dies, we get a really nice death to the side. Like, there's some really nice animation and physics in this. Like, there's some cloth, you know, on him that moves after the fact. Kind of rambling right now. YouTube's really weird, where all the big YouTubers are saying, oh no, people are miscellaneous unsubscribing, and YouTube's posting on their page, no, we're not. We're getting rid of old, inactive subs. And I'm thinking, well, like, I've lost probably 6,000 inactive this month, and I think it was like 12 the month before, and I think it was, when they told us about it, 5 all at once. And I'm fine with losing people that aren't actually there, because personally, I'd rather see a truer reflection of actually who's watching. If you know what I'm saying, like, I don't care if it's got 180K if I've only got 20,000 watching or 30,000, and I'd rather have a truer number. And I believe that I'm hoping they are out there, but I'm starting to doubt whether they are. I'm getting back into the belief that it's me, and that's why I'm trying harder. I think I owe it to not only myself, but to you guys, to produce the best content I can, and to make it the channel that you guys always wanted, whether it be WoW, whether it be D3, whether it be any other game in the future. I know that when I started this, I had big visions for it, and I'm going to continue to focus on that no matter what the obstacles are. And I'm hoping now that there's a few of the bigger YouTubers complaining, that they'll fix it. And in the process, maybe they'll fix mine. I'm looking forward to the day, guys, where I can say hi to all my old subs. Every time I hop an event channel or something, someone recognizes me. They're like, I recognize your voice. Wait a minute, did you used to do videos on whatever? And they might remember my rating videos. They might even remember way back to my SM videos. And it's nice. It's comforting to know that, yeah, and people still, you know, we all have memories greater than a number of years. But at the same time, it's like, maybe I could have kept those people entertained over the years if it had actually went out to everybody within the last two. It's been 2 years of struggle, but I'm going to push through. I love your support through it all. I didn't want this to be in a whine mode, but it's so on my mind all the time. Like, how can I actually reach everyone? And I don't want to ask, I guess I'm going to ask you guys is, you know, not to your friends. I don't want you guys to subscribe new people. But ask your friends who were subscribed, say, you know what, did you unsubscribe? And if they did, that's cool. You know, people move on. But what's not cool is if they are and they haven't been notified. I just noticed with James, the Nintendo nerd, angry video game guy, somebody mentioned him in a post. I'm thinking, oh, I haven't seen him in a while. Then I thought to myself, did I unsub from him? And I went to his channel, and no, I'm still subscribed. And guess what? He's had 8 videos out in the last 2 months, and I have not seen one thumbnail. Now, there's a difference between me not being notified and me not wanting to watch his channel. I personally watch a few of his videos, but when I'm not notified, I don't watch any of them. Because out of sight, out of mind, guys. And I have a feeling that even though I loved a lot of his work, for example, and let's say I have to put this in perspective to somebody I respect, that has been creative in the YouTube industry. Even though I respect and admire a lot of his work, because it got me out of the habit of watching because I wasn't being notified, when something does pop up, it's a, oh, this person's still around. I might check it out because of curiosity, or I might have moved on because that momentum of entertainment is gone. So it was the latter. I did watch a video today and I thought, okay, cool. And then oddly enough, after I watched it, the next video he made popped up in my sub. And I'm thinking, well, maybe that's the algorithm that they have. And I'm thinking, why should my subs have to, you know, only go out to the algorithm? And secondly, you know, I'm using Facebook as a backup. Facebook's now saying, oh, when you make a post, if you want to pay us more money, you can reach more of your audience. Not I can reach more of other audiences, but they're saying because there's so much information flying at everybody today, yours gets buried. Well, instead of trying to make me pay money, which I hope this doesn't happen on YouTube, why don't you just fix the system? Because let's say one of my best friends, and if it's a best friend, I should know it's their birthday, but let's say it's their birthday. And I don't get notified because it was, you know, everybody's like, oh, look at my little puppy. She's three. And oh, this person's like, oh, look at my garden. And this person's like, oh, look, I've got no life, you know. And then it gets pushed down and you miss the important events. I want to see all the events. I don't want to see what some computer's been, you know, figured out. You will be interested in this, not in this. And it boils down to it is if you let the computers think and algorithms think on the subscriber level, then what happens is, you know, what happens if they think blowing this a little bit higher is, oh, well, you've looked at this Republican video, so you must be Republican. So that's all you're going to get inundated with from this point forward, because the computer says, well, he must be Republican. Let's give him more Republican videos. And next thing you know, guess what? You're one way or the other. And you can use the same, I was just using as a Republican as an example, but you see what I mean? When you sub to something, we shouldn't have to be subject to algorithms. We should actually just get it. Just give it to the people who want it. I said this a while ago. When I say, hey guys, I want to say hey to everybody who subscribe. Not just the people that are on now between this time zone. Not just the people that are, you know, anybody who, I want to just notify everybody. And then you can choose to decide whether you want to watch or not. I've had, in the past year, just give you some numbers, 50,000 new subscribers, and I have lost 25,000. So I've grown more than I've lost. The people that have moved on, I accept that they've moved on. They're no longer here, so they can't even hear what I'm saying now. But the new ones, I expect that they should be notified. I went a little longer than I planned today. I'm going to have a few links at the end of the video. Not to any of mine. Mine are all on my channel. But I'm going to have a few links to the other videos of the other YouTubers who are ranting so that you guys can see what's going on. I'm going for these daily videos for a couple of reasons. One, I owe it to you. Two, I owe it to me. I believe that if YouTube doesn't believe in pushing out the videos, the quality of content that I'm trying to create for you guys, I have to do more and hope that you guys will come back and visit me daily. And then that way you guys get to see it without having to worry about a bad delivery system. And I get to actually get your feedback again. I do miss it. People say, oh, you're just saying leave comments so that you can get more money. And it's like, you know what? YouTube has never paid you per comment. No, the comment just gives me feedback. It lets me know that people actually care about the time that I put into these things. And lets me know that you're out there. It's like an audience, you know. I hate to say it. If you were on a stage and you put your heart and soul into a presentation and nobody clapped afterwards, it does affect you. It affects your future performance. You tweak it. You say, okay, well, what could I do to make it better? And when that goes down, you either try to make it better or you say, guess what? This game's not for me. Guys, I'm hoping it's not the latter, but appreciate all your support. And this felt more like a vlog today where I just kind of said what was on my mind. Looking forward to hearing your feedback, whether it be good or bad. Just keep it constructive. Make sure you subscribe so that when YouTube does, you know, fix what it needs to fix, you'll get notified. If not, I'll see you tomorrow.